What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading Windows 10 to Windows 11 using SCCM. So let's get right into that. All right, so within my infrastructure, I have a Windows 10 machine, and it's running right now Windows 10 version 21H1, and I want to upgrade it to Windows 11 build 22H2 because that's the latest one. So within your configuration manager, we are going to head into software, overview, Windows settings, and we're going to go into all Windows feature updates, and we are going to click on add criteria, and I'm going to select on language and then click on add. And then I'm going to click on the little drop-down menu, that hyperlink, and we're going to click on that, and we're going to select our language, and then we're going to click on search. Now, to make more modifications, you are able to search for the build 22H2. At this time, my SCCM did not sync that build, but it's the same approach. You could do the same thing that I'm doing right here. Doesn't change. I've done this on previous videos, so I already downloaded this particular feature update. That's the one I'm going to select, and I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to select on deploy. Now, again, I've done this already. I already reviewed it, and I already downloaded it on my last videos. So hopefully you guys check that out. So this is like a little mini series, like continuing doing different things of like pushing out Windows 11, like upgrading, pushing it out with task sequence and like deploying it and all that stuff to your environment. So this is like a sequence. So hopefully you guys are checking that out. But for this video, I'm not going to do the download and I'm not going to review the license because I already did that on previous videos. So I'm just going to select on deploy. I'm going to give my deployment a name. And I'm going to click on browse and I'm going to select the collection that I want to push this deployment into. So you guessed it, it's going to be the Windows 10 collection. So once I select it, click OK, click next here. For the deployment settings, on the type of deployment, I'm going to click on the drop down menu and then select available. And then I'm going to click on next. For the scheduling, I left everything as the default, click next here. For the user experience, default, click next here. No alerts, next. For download settings, I just make sure I selected download software updates from the DP and install, and then click on next there. You get a nice little summary, so click next. Green check mark, which is always a good thing, and then we're going to select on close. Now, once you do that, you're able to go into the monitor tab, go to deployments, locate your deployment, double click on your deployment, and then eventually on the deployment status section right here, it will take some time. You will see your Windows 10 machines compliant, which is always a good thing. It will take some time for everything to sync up and all your machines to receive the upgrade, but that is how you upgrade your Windows 10 to Windows 11 using your configuration manager. How awesome is that? Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.